Ever since Docker was released in 2013, containers became very popular. A lot of people started creating Docker images so that they can ship the same runtime in all different types of environments and reduce OS-specific dependencies with respect to deploying their artifacts. Since then, there are a lot of different container registries which are provided by different platforms, including the cloud providers. In this video, we are going to take a look at GitHub's package registry, which got recently launched and it is still in beta. Let's also try to create a repository and push these Docker images into the repository specific image registry on our account. Let's get started.
Press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss any update from TechPrimers.
Most of you know that the TechPrimers page has been converted into an organization. So in GitHub, there are two flavors of accounts. One is the personal account, the other one is the organizational account. So I had github.com/techprimers as a personal account. However, later after 100 repositories, I moved it into an organization so that people can directly contribute and it is like an organization. GitHub launched the package registry very recently and it is still in beta. Now I'll be using my TechPrimers organizational account and I'll be showing you how you can build and push images into each repository. In order to sign up for the GitHub package registry, you have to go to github.com/features/package-registry. The link is in the description. You can take a look at it. If you're new to what is Docker, do take a look at the Docker Primer playlist. There are like few videos which you can use to understand what is Docker and how you can build images with Docker. Now coming back to the github.com/techprimers, I have created a new repository called container images. So this is like any other code repository. So if I create a product called, let's say, container images, I can put all my container images inside this repo. For the sake of the demo, I'm going to use a Spring Boot application, which most of us are familiar with. I'll go to start.spring.io. If you're a Java developer, you can use Spring. If you're a Python developer, you can use Python project, or if you're a Go developer, you can use any Go project to try out package registry. I'm going to create a TechPrimers. I'll also rename this as containers demo, and also I'll add dependencies. In order to get my application to be up and running and to test it, I'm going to add the actuator, and also I'll add the Spring Web, because for the actuator to function, I need Spring Web so that it can expose some REST endpoints. So I'll be having two dependencies and that's it. Let's switch to the terminal. I'm in the download section. I can now unzip containers demo project. This should unzip everything into my containers demo folder. If you see that, I have the basic POM XML and inside the POM, I can see some actuator dependency. This is using Java 8 and also I have the starter web dependency. That's it. So this is how a typical Java project looks like, right? So I have a Spring Boot project. Now I am going to package this and push into the containers repository. Now let's go to the container repository. Right now it shows zero packages. So the path for my registry is techprimers/container-images and there is nothing here. See that I can use this package repository for different type of artifacts. In this video, we are going to push a Docker image, but ideally you can leverage it for pushing Maven artifacts or Node artifacts, or in fact, Python and Ruby artifacts as well. So I'm going to use the Docker image to be pushed here. So the steps are provided here, but I'll use the same when I'm using it from my shell here. So in order to create a Docker image, I need a Docker file. So I'll have to create a file called Docker file, and I will have to define what are the different steps I need to follow in creating a Docker image. So I'm going to open the Docker file. I already have copied some content from the Spring Boot guide website, where they have given some four lines where they define, for example, the first line says, I need a OpenJDK 8 Alpine version. Alpine is a lightweight version of OpenJDK with the Linux underneath, right? So I have an OS with OpenJDK 8 installed. And the next step is copying my artifact from the local onto that particular image. So basically this will change into our application specific name. We can change it to containers demo. And the port which this particular application is using is 8080. So I'm not going to change that. So see that the third one is to expose the port, what port my application is using and what port the container can bind it to. And the last step is to start the process. Basically, we are going to do a Java jar and then give the containers demo. That's it. As simple as that, right? I'm not going to create any complicated step here. It's just a Spring Boot application, which is already containerized with a Tomcat. We are just going to wrap the Spring Boot application into a Docker image using this Docker file. In order to build a Docker file, you need to have the Docker desktop up and running if you're using your desktop. So I have already opened Docker desktop and I'm using 2.0.0.3 version of Docker desktop, which is a community edition. Obviously it is free, so I'm using it. I use it with my Minikube, but for this demo I'm going to use it to show you how to build the Docker image and then push it into the container registry. So of course you can use different tools for pushing and building Docker images. For example, Scaffold is one of the tool which you will be seeing in the later videos, but in this video we are going to use the Docker CLI. So I'm going to use the Docker CLI. The version of the Docker CLI is 18.0.9.2. That's the version I am using. Now the next step is to build the artifact before building the Docker file, right? So if you look at it, I don't have the target folder like I mentioned in the Docker file. So I need to do a Maven wrapper clean install. This will create my artifacts in the target folder, right? So I'm just building my project so that it can create an artifact out of it. So basically the jar file. So this is going to create a jar file under the target folder. So lslrt target. So look at that, I have some jar file called containers demo -0.0.snapshot, but I wanted it as a containers -demo.jar, right? So I'll just move this target folder containers to target containers -demo.jar. So I have the containers.demo.jar, and inside my Docker file I can see that it's going to get copied from target onto the image, right? So now I can run my Docker build. So Docker build, I'm going to give the Docker build command and I'll say that read the Docker file from the current directory, which is the third argument. And the final argument I'm going to give is the tag. So what is the tag name with which I want to tag my image with? So I'm going to use a containers demo example and I'll say V1. So tag my particular build with V1. See that the image got built. The first step was to download the OpenJDK 8 JDK Alpine, and Docker did it. The second line was to copy the artifacts from my local onto the Docker image. Third one was to expose the application when it comes up. And finally, the entry point is when the Docker image will run the application when we start it. Right now, we just build the image. Now I'll do a clear again. Let's look at the images. The moment I do a Docker images, I can see that OpenJDK got downloaded with the tag 8 JDK Alpine, and also one more repository was created called containers demo with a version 1 tag. So that is what we built a few seconds ago. Now I need to first check if this is running, right? So I'm going to run the Docker image using the command docker run. So you can use docker run and you can give the name of your application or the repository. So I'm just saying containers demo, use my V1 and use the port 8080 and expose the container in the same port, because container is exposing the 8080 port. I'm exposing the container in the same port. So I'm just giving docker run containers demo v1-p8080. This will start the whole Docker container along with my application. See that the application is up and running. Should be good, right? So application is fine. Now I'm just going to push this particular Docker container into my container registry. That's what we wanted, right? In order to do that, you can login into the Docker CLI using the Docker login. I have already done a Docker login. If you want to use the image which is already present in the repository, you can use this particular token. So give this as a password. The username will be moving to web, and use this as a password so that you can download the images and try out by running the same image in your local. But for now, I have a different password because I need to have a write permission. So I have created a separate token for that purpose. Let me go back to the terminal. I have already done the Docker login, so I don't need to do that. Now, in order to push my image to the container registry, I need to use the Docker push command. The moment I do a Docker push, I need to give the whole path because this is a different URL, right? For that purpose, I should tag my images with a different name, because by default, it will go to the Docker hub only. I need to push it into a different repository. So I need to create a different tag for my image. So for that, I'm going to do a Docker tag, and I'm going to tag my Docker repository, the version, with a different tag. So what tag should I use? For that purpose, if you look at the documentation here and click on Docker, so the documentation clearly says your app needs to be tagged with docker.pkg.github/your account/your repo, right? So I'm going to use the same URL slash, my account name is called TechPrimers, that's the repository name, right? And the other thing is it's all lowercase, right? So always use lowercase because the URL of the Docker registry is lowercase in this case. So I'm going to use docker.packaging.github.com/techprimers, and the name of the repository is called container-images, right? Let's check once. It's called container-images, correct? Now I need to push an image called containers-demo, and what is the version? V1. So I'm tagging my containers demo V1 as the whole URL here. That way, the whole Docker CLI will understand that I need to push it there. So that's it. The moment I do a Docker images now, I can see one more tag, which is exactly the same as this guy, right? So one more Docker image got created and I'll be able to push that. Now let me do a clear again. Now in order to push it, I need to do a Docker push, and now I can define the same name, whatever name I had given. Okay, I think I copied the whole thing. So it's basically the docker.packaging.github.com/techprimers/container-images/containers-demo:V1. So this is the command to push our local repository to the GitHub package registry. So this could be GitHub, or it could be Google Cloud, it could be Amazon's repository or Azure's image repository. It could be anything. Right now, this is going to get pushed onto our GitHub repository. So let me go to the Git. Let me refresh this so that you can see if this is getting changed. Yes. So this now got changed into one package. Now if I go there, I can see I have a containers demo, right? And if I click on it, I can see that my image is present here. Most of the time, what happens? People use this particular packaging registry for using it as a release notes along with exposing the image. Now, if I want to add some description, I can add that here. So I can add a description defining what is the reason I created this particular container and what does this contain. So this is like a release note as well, in addition to holding the container. So I'm not going to add anything right now, but this is how we can push the container image. Now let's say I want to push a new version, right? What will I do? I'll do a Docker build with a new tag. So quickly it got built again. Now I need to do a tag again. I need to do the tag for version 2. So tagging is done. Now I can do a push. Again, I need to give version 2. This again immediately pushes the image. Now let me go back to the repository. The moment I do a refresh, and I can see that version 2 is getting reflected here. And that's the latest version. If you want to see the older versions, you have a way to see that here. And if you want to pull and use this particular image, you can use the commands which are defined here. So it's a proper container registry which you can leverage, and it's completely free because it's inside GitHub again. If you don't have a way to push your Docker images somewhere, you can definitely push your Docker images onto the same repository where you have written some code. In this case, I don't have the code here, but ideally you can have the code present here and also the package present inside the same repository so that people can come in and then take these Docker containers and work on it. I hope you are able to understand how to leverage the container registry inside the GitHub repo. So the package registry inside GitHub additionally supports NPM, Maven, Python and Ruby artifacts as well. If you want any specific video on any of these artifacts, do let me know. But I think it's quite simple and similar to what I did here, right? Instead of just using Docker CLI, you will be using the NPM and the Maven or the NuGet CLI. I hope you found this particular video interesting and useful. As always, if you like the video, go ahead and like it. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, go ahead and subscribe to it. Meet you again in the next video. Thank you very much.